Tourism businesses on the Greek island of Lesbos are asking for protection from bankruptcy as they face a potential economic catastrophe. Tens of thousands of vacationers, normally expected on one of Greece's more idyllic spots, are staying away because of the island's central role as a landing zone for refugees. Now, the islanders are appealing for what they call solidarity tourism. Special correspondent Malcolm Brabant reports from Lesbos.
I've seen a cormorant, I've seen a Rupel's warbler, I've seen a subalpine warbler.
Every year, spring in Lesbos lures millions of migrating birds and British pensioner Helen Steadman. Unlike other tourists, troubled by images of suffering and misery, she and her keen birdwatching partner, Jeff Bailey, have remained faithful to an island they believe typifies unadulterated Greece.
I feel sad for the islanders. The economy is suffering, and we've noticed that restaurants that we favoured before have closed. They're not there anymore. They've gone bankrupt. The locals can't afford to pay wages, and they're just not opening. Tourism is their biggest income in this island, and if we don't come and support them, then they're not going to survive.
Seasonal worker Nikos Paspalatelis is helping his former boss prepare this hotel for the summer. Married with two small children, Paspalatelis has worked here for almost 20 years, but he's been laid off this summer, which means his state insurance won't be paid, which means he won't be entitled to unemployment benefit in the winter when there's no seasonal work.
I'm not going to say that we're angry, because angry is something if somebody make you very big damage to you, but this is, I hope so to be only for 1 year, this damage. Maybe if you ask me, maybe in 2-3 years, if this situation continue, I said yes, I'm going to be angry.
This hotel was on the front line. The owners estimate more than 1,000 boats landed on the beach next to their taverna, most during the peak season. And at the same time, German water sports instructor Wolfgang Punker has come to say farewell and remove his gear.
Oh, I have to pack up, because in Europe, in the television, you get almost every 2/3 or 4th day information about Lesbos, about the refugees. And you think Lesbos is full of refugees, and so the booking numbers are going down up to zero.
Hotelier Dimitrios Vatis, whom we met at the start of the refugee crisis, shows us the difference between bookings for last year, which started so promisingly, and this.
This year, the difference between the two of them is minus 88.28%.
This business, along with hundreds of others on Lesbos, could be in serious trouble. They face double the pressure, extra tax demands, to help with Greece's other crisis, its debt burden. The hotelier is appealing to the government to protect vulnerable enterprises from bank foreclosures as they try to survive. But his prime concern is for loyal employees that he's been forced to let go.
In a little while, these people, they may end up asking jobs somewhere else. So they'll be refugees. I feel badly, terribly, when I'm talking about the rest of the people that they work in this hotel and they're not going to be able to have a job this summer.
Day trippers from Turkey who've taken the legal ferry to cross the Aegean climb one of Lesbos' main attractions, the chapel in Petra, the Rock. But their custom in no way replaces that of the 90,000 foreign visitors the island anticipated before the crisis. The islanders were being talked about as potential Nobel Peace Prize nominees for their generosity and hospitality. The sense of rejection pains cafe owner Stelios Chiotelis, who is a stone's throw from the chapel. Not only is his business being jeopardized by the tourists staying away, but also by foreign package holiday companies which are trying to force the islanders to cut their prices still further.
All the locals here, they did the best they could to help the refugees last year when they first came out. There wasn't NGOs here, there was nothing. So we give them food, drinks. Many people help a lot. I will not say that I help a lot, but we do our best. And then instead of people appreciate that and say like, oh, these people help, they turn the back to us now, like they cancel all the flights.
This is Eresos, home to Sappho, the ancient Greek poet who wrote of romantic love between women. This village is one of the world's leading lesbian destinations. Its location on the west of the island shielded it from the armada of rafts. Despite its prominence in a niche market, Eresos is also facing a bleak future. Local tourist chief Fanny Gallinou.
We don't know how long will be the season. We have guests that they want to come, but they don't know how, or it is very expensive for them because there are no any more charter flights. We had 25 charter flights per week, and now we have only 10.
For a place that's had such a turbulent year and whose geographical position has guaranteed it prominence in 21st century history, Lesbos can be disarmingly tranquil.
He's gone now.
Birdwatcher Jeff Bailey has great sympathy with the people escaping war, oppression and poverty, and has this message for holidaymakers worried about the migrant crisis.
Well, I think the island is looking as wonderful as always, and I would urge anybody who wants to come to the island, you know, to please come to the island. The issues with the migrants, the vast majority of the island, you won't experience that. And so there's no reason for you not to come.
Last summer, Lesbos was inundated as the authorities failed to cope with the refugee crisis. But now the system is much more organised as the European Union tries to get control of its external borders. Irrespective of the rights and wrongs, the reality is that the refugees and migrants are now being kept away from the main tourist areas. The village of Molivos, with its medieval citadel, has endured a torrid 12 months and witnessed significant tragedy. But the apocalyptic scenes in its cobbled streets have evaporated. Although she has to work two jobs, 15 hours a day, 7 days a week, restaurateur Yana Stipsanu takes a long historical view and is optimistic.
It's famous. Everybody knows Lesbos. And it knows exactly also the good things we have. It's the people, the hospitality, and how beautiful is the place and how beautiful the people are and how secure and safe you are when you're here with us.
While the islanders' short-term plea is for tourists to return, their more substantive desire is for the world powers to bring peace to conflict zones so that people no longer need to use these shores as a stepping stone. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Lesbos.
And now some news about our own reporting. Today, the PBS NewsHour won a 2015 Peabody Award for Desperate Journey. Our extensive reporting on the European migrant crisis, Malcolm Brabant, who just reported our story from Lesbos, has led much of the coverage on the ground from across the region. You can find all our reports online on our homepage at pbs.org/newshour.